What causes us to Timothy 1:6. For the love of money is the root of all. Last verse. 2 Timothy 4:2. 4:2. Paul complained, he said, for Timothy forsaken me because he loved the word. The word again. Brothers and sisters, young members of God's family, the Lord loves you with an agape love, but don't wish to continue sticking with that love, no matter what it is. Because our love is also trying to counterbalance the love of God. Love is enjoyable, right? Some of you cannot see it. Some of you cannot see it when you feel in love. Some of you don't know how to walk or behave when you feel in love. Don't see it in loving your neighbor and your neighbor. Because love is sweet. Sin is sweet. The Proverb says, it's stolen bread is so sweet. Have you tried stolen bread? We need to look at it from this perspective. Now, Romans 6:14 says, do not let sin reign over your mortal body. Do not let sin reign. The word reign is a royal word. It's a king. Sin wants to be a king in our life, but we need prison. Verse 16, sin has no dominion over you. The word dominion is again, it's a real word. What sin wants to extend is territory on your brain, in your heart, in your hands, and you become fanatic of doing evil things. I want to end this with a very serious word in the book of Philippians. Let's go to Philippians chapter 3. I want you to look at chapter 3, verses 4 to 9. Paul again is summarizing his love, his own personal understanding of his assets. And I think you are with him. I am with him. Let's read the verses. Paul says, it's 7, verse 4. No, I also might have confidence in flesh. If anyone else thinks that he may have confidence in flesh, I am more. Because most of the time we trust ourselves. We trust the name of our family, our academic performance, our friends, who we are. That seems to be an asset. Right? This morning, Pastor Ruben says, if you are beautiful, that's an asset. If you are handsome, still an asset. But if you are very handsome, that's a questionable asset. If you are extremely beautiful, that is also a liability. Here Paul is saying, he said, son of Israel, in the driving of Benjamin, Hebrews of Hebrews, concerning the law of Pharisee, concerning the same, persecuting the church, persecuting righteousness, which is the law of blameless. But what things were gained to me is I have found the lost for Christ. Wow. When we look at ourselves, because sometimes ourselves always come to the front because we have lost this to ourselves. Right? Paul says, I have all of these assets. But when it comes to Christ, he says, all I lost because we are all rubbish. Let's read
him. Now, hanging round the righteousness, which is not, but the righteousness which is by faith in Jesus Christ, the righteousness of God.
What a beautiful expression.
Meaning to say, Paul is talking the way how I understand it. Let us put into the hands of God our liabilities, our sinful nature, our sinful tending towards sin, our attractiveness to sin. Because when we place it in God's hands, we count the blood and what comes by redemption and creation, you are the asset, genuine, divine asset of God. Knowing this, since you are involved in the youth ministry, we discussed this morning, ministry is one service. Ministry is an act of worship, it's an act of dedication, because there is higher than us, and there is no more enjoyable and more exciting and more productive life than to be in the ministry. And you are the wrong in joining, but what you need. Understand the Lord, put all of my abilities in your hands, and turn them into your asset, and you can use them. This is what he did. And so, when Paul is sick, this is your involved in the most effective worship. Invest that light, sanctify life, and likely there's something. It's just like I became a Seventh-day Adventist. It's like I'm just a church member. I was an altar boy. I was supposed to be a cardinal now because my name speaks of the qualification. But that's cool. When I was supposed to graduate 4 years, my four altar boys were just a Christian. All of them become priests except me. And it's not a little bit back of my head, but I think I have a candidate for cardinal. But God has changed my life, my perspective. Although I suffer, but yet we cannot enjoy the crown without suffering. Suffering is an indication that God loves us so much because it costs the life of His Son. I'm sorry, it's something else. I want to put in your life. There are several questions I'm supposed to ask. But one question I would like, if God is calling you, is calling his response, and give your all, and he will give your all what you need. This is my mission to present.